It was a normal flight day. We were going out to repunch currency for landing at the ship in the evening. There was nothing crazy about it. I took off, and as I was climbing away from the deck, I put my gear up. Realized I had a gear malfunction, so I immediately pulled the power back, slowed the aircraft down so I wouldn't overspeed the landing gear. And then went just above the ship at about 2,000 feet and started talking to Paddles, who is another jet pilot in the tower that controls us when we land. They're also up there if we have a problem. They have they're a book reader. They help us walk through the situation since we're a single piloted aircraft. For a little while, I flew by the ship, did an approach at 300 feet so he could see my landing gear and give me an idea of what was going on, and determined that my nose gear did not come back down. At this point, it's time to figure out how do I get the jet back on the deck safely with only three landing gear. So eventually Major Murphy came over the radio and told me that the ship had this amazing invention that was like basically a stool that was built specifically for this reason. The ship has a lighting system on what we call spot 7 that we use to land at an exact spot every time. So the difference with this landing was that I was going to step it down 50, 40, 30, 20 feet to make sure I was aligned and stabilized before Major Murphy would clear me to land at 20 feet so that it had the best chance to actually put the nose on the stool. So I come in, and at this point I've kind of forgotten that I don't have a nose gear. I'm just focused on landing. That's what I decided I had to do. So I'm at 20 feet stabilized, and I can't see the stool. I don't even know it's there. I didn't see it coming over the end of the ship. I looked for it. I remember looking for it and thinking, oh boy, this is going to get interesting. So I never saw the stool. So I go to idle. I remember my main gear hitting and all of a sudden my nose dropping, and it dropped more than I expected. But at that point, I was alone for the ride. I don't remember feeling it bounce like it did on the videotape. I remember feeling it just kind of hit and that was it. But then I had to sit there for a minute and remember how to shut the jet off and everything. It was pretty big relief. I didn't realize how much I was shaking until I got out of the aircraft. The most interesting part, looking back at the video and watching the video, was I didn't realize that nobody was on the flight deck when I came over to land in case something went bad. Now that was neat, having everyone come out and congratulating me and stuff. It was a little overwhelming at first. For a moment, I just wanted to catch my breath. We pride ourselves at landing on the ship perfectly like this, in the same spot every time, and doing the same thing over and over again. But there's no way to train to land in this kind of situation.